One of the most important skills you can learn when you start to use Zoho CRM is creating views. Views are pre-built, filtered lists with specific columns displayed. They're available for all of the modules and can be accessed using this drop-down at the upper left corner of each of the views. Some views are built in. If I scroll to the bottom, you'll see shared with me. That's usually the ones that are built in, although some other people may have shared their views with you. Then you can have views that you've built yourself. You can see I have quite a few different views. And then, of course, you can favorite some of your views. While you can certainly filter any list at the left using the filters, for instance, I can say, give me a list of every place where the email is not empty, and I can apply the filter. That would be a great way to do something very temporarily. However, there are two main advantages to creating a view that already displays that. One is if you or others needed this filtered view frequently, it's quicker to create the view, so you can just quickly click on it. Or if you want to export this list, the problem would be it would not export the filtered list, it would export everything in the list. So the filter does not affect what gets exported. So let's create a simple view and then build on it. I'm going to click the drop-down area to go to the bottom of the list and select Create View. First, you'll want to name the view, so I might want to say Contacts with Email. Then I'll specify the criteria. So I'll just pick the email. Rather than scroll to it, I'm just going to start to type the name of the field so that I can find it very quickly and say that the email is not empty. In other words, there's something in the email field. After you've done your criteria, you'll select the columns you want to display. So this looks fine with me, just the first name, last name, phone, and email. Then, although I could add other names, let's put the account name over here. Then you determine who should be able to see this view. Only me works so that only you can see it. However, just be advised that all administrators in the account can see it. I can let everyone see this, which is good if this works for a lot of people in your company. Or I can pick selected users. I can pick specific users to say I only want Scott or David to see this. Or I can pick by roles, or I can click by groups. There are a lot of different ways you can select who should be able to see this view. It's not going to restrict the people that are in this view. It just means that when you have that drop-down list, sometimes the list can be quite overwhelming if a lot of people in your organization are creating views. So I'm just going to say everyone for right now and click Save. So good, I've got a list of 16. I have a kind of a narrow list that I'm playing with here. So that gives me the list, but actually I have another field in my database that says who wants to receive tips. So let's edit and expand on this list. I'm going to come to the first criteria, and out to the right there's a little plus sign. And I'm going to say not only is the email not empty, but there are tips preference contains Zoho. So that gives me another option. So I want to see that just to be sure. So I'm going to scroll here and find tips preference and double click it to launch it over to the right. I also want to, take off phone field. I don't really need that. And I want to include another field that I have called ID status. And click Save. Let's see what it looks like so far. So now I've narrowed that list down to only 7 people. But I noticed the reason I wanted to do that was that I see that I have some vendors in my list. I definitely don't want that. So I'm going to edit my list again and add another criteria. And that field that was ID status doesn't contain the word vendor. And now I'm going to click Save. So now I have my completed list of who I might send something to. But let's look at some other things. I want to maybe go to Deals and show you some options there as well. So I'm going to go back to all open deals, or let's go to all deals and start with that. Maybe I want to create a list of my open deals, because you would think that would come with Zoho, but it doesn't. So I'm just going to, again, click on the drop-down and go to the bottom of the view and say my open deal. And of course, so you have to think about, the first word is my, so that means you'll need to find the owner, so which is the deal owner or the potential owner or the opportunity owner, depending on what you've named your opportunities or potentials module. The deal owner is, look, there's a special one over here. You could select a specific user, but you could also say the logged in user. So that way it will work for everyone in your organization. So I have two things. It's my, and it's also open. So I want to add another factor and say the stage doesn't contain, I might say closed, not any of those options. Then of course, again, you'll want to pick which of the fields that you'd like to display, and I could say bring over account name, or I could bring over any field that you want to. And I would, again, I'm going to let everyone see this because it's going to be unique to each person, because whoever's logged in, they'll only see their own deals, and I'm going to click save. So now the list is narrowed to just only my open deals. But let's add one more element to it and add another criteria. So I want to say and the close date is, and look at some of the, when you're working with a date field, notice some of the keywords that you can use. The closing date is today, which would not be a great one, but, or starting tomorrow, that would be all future deals. The closing date is till yesterday, that means all past due deals. I might want to look, I want to look at these two at the bottom to talk to you about those. Due in days would be, the closing date would be in the future. It's due in 90 days or less. Age in days always refers to history. The closing date is 90 days old. So I want to work on the due in days. It's due in days less than or equal to 90. And then I'm going to click save. I have one deal coming up in 90 days. Finally, I want to look at one other view that might be helpful. I'm not going to create this one, but I want to look at how it was created and discuss it with you. So this is one that I created called My Today. I'm going to edit it. It has a lot of criteria, but I wanted to read it through it. So this is, the activity owner is the logged in user, because that's the my part. The due date, that's for tasks, is today. So that was one of the options that I could have. And the status isn't completed. You can pick any of the other values if you have other values. But notice I have an or condition here between the different criteria. So the activity owner is, again, the logged in user, and the from. So that means this would be an event. The due date is always associated with a task. The from is associated with an event. Or the activity owner is the logged in user, and the call start time is today, and it's scheduled or overdue. The reason I wanted to show you this is, one, is to show the or conditions. And whenever you get into or conditions, you will always need to edit the pattern. And I'm just going to delete all this so I can create it from scratch here. So basically, it's the old math order of operations, if you remember that from high school, which is solve for things in a certain order. In this case, I want to manually type it and say I want 1 and 2 and 3. Solve that first. Then, or 4 and 5. Oh, I forgot to put an open parenthesis, sorry. Or 6 and 7 and here is the trick, 8 or 9. So I want those, and this is kind of one of those, either you, it helps to understand or to look through the math here, but if I say 8 or 9, well, I can't type the 9, there we go, 8 or 9, and then I want to close it. So I want to say, I don't care, the activity owner is the logged in person and the call start time is today, and I don't care whether the call status is scheduled or overdue. So those all belong together in one string. So now I have, I'm going to click save, and now I have a good pattern, and I'm going to click save again. It's a really great view to have. It's a way, I like the fact that I can always display my today and see it on my calendar. I mostly put it on my home screen. It's always the left panel at the top of the list. Just in case you didn't know this, I'm just going to go create one for you. You would go down to the bottom of the list and add a component that is a custom view, and any view that you've created. I just created that one or looked at that one in activities, and the custom view is my today, or maybe it's my past due, however you want to do it. I always give the name the same. My today, we'll just call it one because I've already got one on the screen. I'm going to click save. Yeah, I've already added that one. So basically that would be how I would add it, and it would add it to my screen, and then I move it to the top of the list so that every day when I log in, I see what I have on my list today. Don't forget that when you create a view, and if you like that view quite a bit, you can favorite it. This is the one I just created. If you point to the left, there's a silver star. If you click on the silver star, it will put a gold star in it, and it will move it to the top of the list. So now that here's my contacts with email at the top of the list.
Hi, it's Susan. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, do me two favors. One, subscribe to the channel so that you'll get an email notice each time I upload a new video. And two, go to my website, zcrmhelp.com, and sign up for my Zoho tips. While you're there, if you like, you can order a copy of my book, Zoho CRM Quick Study Guide. It'll help you be even more productive in your use of Zoho. Until next time.